Yeah.
Okay. One of the things we need to explore when we're teaching information literacy skills to students is how to do a good literature search. They can all do bad literature searches. That's just not a problem. They can all put keywords into Google. That isn't the issue. The issue is to make them think about the search before they start and then approach it in quite a systematic way. And the first step is to get them to think of some suitable keywords for the topic that they're trying to search. I was teaching some some social policy students the other day, and the question they were looking at was, can health campaigns be effective in improving the diet of children? And they could all instantly put in keywords for health campaign, diet, and children. But the challenge is to get them to think about other ways of expressing that as an idea and other information that might be useful in researching that as a topic but that isn't reflected in the keywords. So health campaigns could take place in schools, and they might be targeted to particular groups of children, so it might be teenagers or preschool or nursery children, and your keywords would be different depending on what area you're focusing on or if you wanted to capture everything. And talking to Laura, we had a very good conversation. I couldn't find a prop. I mean, I at first I was looking for something that could just be described in lots of different ways. So you could call a shoe, a trainer, a running shoe, a stiletto, a Jimmy Choo. It's easy to find something that has lots of synonyms. But actually, what I wanted to focus on was finding lots of synonyms, but also organising those so they made a sensible search. And Laura, because she was thinking about apps for her topic, made me think about perhaps using some mind mapping software. So as a result of this exercise around the Armdale, I'm going to go back to the university and check out what mind mapping software we've got. I know we've got a couple of things. I'm going to look at those and see if I can devise an exercise in a class that will get students to analyse particular questions and then organise